What's up, guys? My name is Pastor Lainee, and welcome to Pursuit Kids Corner, where today we will be learning about setting the standard in your life. So go grab your supplies and get back here quickly so we can get started. All right, welcome back. So we're going to go straight into our promised scripture today. If you have your Bibles, open them up to 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 12. 1 Timothy is found in the New Testament, so make your way that way. And it says, "Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, conduct, love, spirit, faith, and impurity." These six things we'll be digging into today, and you're gonna love it, but make sure you write down this promise scripture, get it in your hearts and in your mind. All right, it's time for praise and worship. So let's stand up on our feet. Let's dance around. Let's shout in your room unto the Lord, because we'll be worshiping the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords right now.
Waking up to another light. No more sorrow and no more night. You're the light, let it shine now. Let it shine now. Burning bright, cause we're not ashamed. Got a world to illuminate. You're the light, let it shine now. Let it shine now.
Shine a light, 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 shine
Welcome back, guys. We're going to get started in our lesson about setting the standard in your life. We're going into the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah was written between 460 BC and 580 BC. You want to know who wrote this book? That's right, Jeremiah did. The purpose for this book was to warn Judea against rebellion. Jeremiah proclaimed God's message to Judea and Israel to repent and turn to God. He knew what was ahead on this journey for this country, and he was very sad for the message that he would have to deliver to these people. Jeremiah was often called the weeping prophet, knowing that he would have to deliver this word to people who would rebel against God anyways, which made him really sad. And this is where you see Jeremiah step into place about setting the standard for all of the people around him. We're going to go into Jeremiah chapter 1, so turn to your Bibles and get to that book. And we're going to start chapter 1, verse 4. And this is where we'll see God calling Jeremiah to do his will. Let's start in verse 4. Then the word of the Lord came to me saying, "Before I formed you in your womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I sanctified you. I ordained you a prophet to the nations." And then Jeremiah said, "Ah, Lord God, behold, I cannot speak, for I am youth." But the Lord said to Jeremiah, "Do not say, 'I am a youth,' for you shall go to all of whom I send you, and whatever I command you, you shall speak. Do not be afraid of their faces, for I am with you and will deliver you, says the Lord." Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched Jeremiah's mouth and said, "Behold, I have put my words in your mouth. See, I have this day set you over the nations and over kingdoms, to root out and to pull down, to destroy and to throw down, to build and to plant." What an amazing call that God's put on Jeremiah's life, right? That's pretty intense, huh? Well, as we see Jeremiah's life pan out, he was a faithful servant to God and went all throughout Israel preaching the gospel and helping the Israelites remain obedient to God's word, even when it got really hard for him, because he faced some various challenges. You'll see more about Jeremiah in some of our upcoming videos, so be ready and be watchful. In chapter 1, we see Jeremiah wasn't too sure about what God was calling him to do. He was young, and he didn't think that anyone would listen to him. But nevertheless, Jeremiah went and did all of what God told him to do. Now, do you have your promise scripture handy? Let's take a look at that. In 1 Timothy 4:12, let's read it together if you're watching this with me. "Let no one despise your youth, but be an example to the believers in word, conduct, love, spirit, faith, and purity." God's word is speaking to you today, and it's also calling you out. It's setting a standard or a bar for you to reach to. Let's look at the first half of our promise scripture together. You ready to break it down a little bit? It says that let no one despise you for your youth. Does that sound familiar? Maybe whenever Jeremiah was scared because he was too young to do what God called him to do. Let's look at this word despise. This word despise means to think less of. Just because you're young does not mean that you don't have something to say or something to contribute to. You're never too young. So for example, if you are walking around the park and you're walking full of joy, full of laughter, and you see someone sitting off to the side that is sad, maybe even older than you, you can go over and encourage them and pray for them and let them know that they can have the joy of the Lord that can strengthen them. Because you are never too young to share the love of God with everyone around you. You should be a light in the dark places that need to hear God's word. So when you're at school and your friends are trying to talk bad about people and make fun of people or even push someone around, share the light of the word of God. Now, you're probably thinking, how do I share light? What does that even mean? Well, have you ever seen bugs flying around a light? This was a light. You'd see them flying around. Sometimes more at night, you can see it as well. But there's just something about that light that is so attractive. And they just hover around it all night. You just see bugs flying around, right? Well, when you're sharing God's word, it should attract people to you because they are searching for a true joy, a true peace, and all of what God's word says that they can have. They're looking for that. And guess what? God's word is attractive, just that, like that light that bugs try to hover around. When you start speaking God's word, it's attractive and it attracts people to you as well. Now let's look at the last half of our scripture. It says, be an example to the believers. There's six things that we need to be an example to, which is in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. If you believe that God's word is truth, if you believe that Jesus is your Lord and Savior, let it show every day, everywhere, to everyone, all of the time. That's one thing that God is calling you to do, to set that standard in your life, to minister the gospel, to speak it out, and to help everyone around you. Because you know what? You are never too young to start today. Right after you get done watching this video, you can go out and share the love of God. But before you do that, let's break down these six areas to help us raise the standard and raise the bar of living in the Word of God and living this faith life out. Are you ready? Number one, in word. Let's see how we do this. Everything that you say should glorify God. Our words matter to God. Because some of us like to talk way too much. Are you a talkative person? Well, when we talk too much, what are we not doing? Listening. Proverbs 10:19 in our Bible says, in a multitude of words, sin is not lacking, but he who restrains his lips is wise. How can you listen when you're talking? Maybe try it. Can you talk and listen to me at the same time? It's really hard to do. I've tried. The next thing that we can do is walk this word out in conduct. Say conduct. This means how you act or how you behave. Do your actions glorify God today? When someone says something mean to you, do you say something mean back? When your little brother does something or bothers you or pushes you, do you do it back to him? When you're at school, are you treating someone mean and do you cause people to join in with you while you're being like that? What are you acting like? Maybe when your parents ask you to clean up your room, do you say you will, but then you don't? Do you lie to protect yourself from others? These are all things that should help us act right, instead of acting against God's word. The third thing is love. How you love your neighbor, your friends, or your stranger. It does need to reflect God's love. So let's take a think. How I love my friends, is that how God loves me? And is that how I need to show God's love? Why does love matter so much? You see a lot in the Bible. But because love is the center of it all of what God has done for us is because of love. You can read Romans 5:8 to see that. Because God is love. The fourth thing is walking in spirit, letting the Holy Spirit lead and guide you. Jesus told us before he went back up to heaven that he was going to send us a helper and that he would guide us in all truth. That's found in John 14:26. Let the Holy Spirit lead you in your life. Raise that standard, remember. Our fifth thing is faith. Believing and trusting and leaning fully on God in confidence. Anything that we read in the Bible, we need to listen to and by faith, live it out. Do it. Go after it. If the Bible says to not worry about anything, but pray about everything, Philippians 4:6. Then living by faith, I would take my worries to God, and I would pray about them, and I would trust him that he would get me through this. By all means, nothing would stop that from coming to pass, because God always answers our prayers. Our last thing and our sixth thing is purity. Purity means to have moral character. So for example, if the world or your friends say that it's okay to go watch a bad movie, is it really okay? No, because anything that you put in your mind will be with you forever. Purity keeps your mind and heart away from those things that could cause you to sin. Now, why do we need to do these six things? Well, our life needs to match what we say we believe in. Paul teaches us in our promise scripture that leadership is a matter of godly character. God cares about who you are more than what you say you are. So let's stop today and think about your life and your actions. Make sure that they line up with our promise scripture and what it says to us. Maybe take time today to ask yourself, am I showing love to my siblings today? Even though they're annoying, even though they keep bothering me. Am I talking nice and honoring my parents? Jesus came to this world to save the lost, and it's your calling to take the word of God that is spoken to you and to share it with all of the world. Let's live that standard. Let's make sure that we don't live below what God's word is telling us to do. These things can help you grow into a mighty man, into a mighty woman of God. All right, kids, this is our craft for our lesson today. This is called a thought bubble or a thought cloud. And what I'd like you to do is grab a piece of paper. It can be A3 or whatever you have lying around. But I want you to create this little thought cloud. And this is going to represent how you should think about how you walk in word, in conduct, in love, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. And then I want you to write down what you learned today, what stuck out to you today. Those 6 points that I mentioned to you, I want you to personally write down which ones you thought were the best, or which ones you were like, ooh, I think I probably need to work on that one. What I did was I colored it, I made it nice and crafty, I put little stamps around, I made it nice and, you know, bright. But I wrote down here, I want to think about walking in love, in the word, and in purity. And then I've written down here that I want to think about how I walk in love towards people, or how I want to be helped in walking in the word of God, to help memorize scriptures. And then in purity, to help me walk in purity of my mind, even when no one's around. But when I'm by myself, I want to make sure my mind is set on God. Make sure you do this. We'd love to see some pictures of what you have crafted and created. So you can email us at kids@pursuitchurchmornington.com.au. And you can send us what you've created. We'd love to see it. Let's pray. Father, we come to you in Jesus' name. And I thank you for each and every kid that's watching. Heavenly Father, I thank you that you help them walk in conduct, in love, in the word, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. I thank you that you are helping them, Holy Spirit, lead and guide them into all righteousness, into all truth today. I thank you that they are growing to be bold, mighty men and women of God, full of faith to expand the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name, amen. See you later, guys.